Hey guys!
So we're here today to do a video from Sabaton, a cover. We've done four covers on the channel.
Yeah.
Kingdom Come, Twilight of the Thunder God.
And then Flocking Bjorn did In the Air Me Now.
In the Air Me Now. So this is the fourth. Okay, so this is the fourth. Alright. Alright, this is the fourth. I thought we did four and this was the fifth.
Yeah.
But no, this is the fourth. Alright, so before we talk about this specific song, this specific video, this is not a video, by the way, this is just the audio. They obviously don't have a video for this song. Well, maybe not so obvious, but they don't have it, so I'm just using the audio. But anyways, before we talk about this, I want to tell the folks at home what came through my mind yesterday, because it's Sabaton related. So what I like to do when I'm shaving and I'm listening to music is I like to take a song that I know, and lyrics that I know, and then exactly butcher the lyrics and make it my own.
And I know you do that because I'm trying to sleep and all I hear is just you butchering the lyrics of songs.
I do this. This is a long-lasting tradition in my family. My brother did it before me. I do it now. I don't know. Maybe it's a Portuguese thing. We like to butcher lyrics. So anyways, I was listening to Winged Hussars. And as the chorus comes about, you know, like the chorus says, in the winged Hussars coming down the mountainside, whatever the lyrics go. Because I don't want to lose track of what I'm going to say. So as I'm listening to that and the lyric and the chorus is about to come in, I go, in the wings and the hot sauce tonight. Coming down the mountainside. And then I told you about this.
And then we had like a conversation.
On the subway.
Yeah.
As we were traveling on the subway. And we had about 30-minute conversation about the lyrics. Because then it was like, and in December came September. And then you're like, how in December can September come? And I was like, it doesn't have to make sense. It just has to sound like the real thing.
Yeah, but then we were talking about, okay, so why would the hot sauce and the chicken wings be there? And then
because the Hussars were hungry.
Yeah, that's a...
Yeah, they didn't have pizza delivery back then, but I'm sure they could swing some wings and a hot sauce.
Yeah.
Because they're winged Hussars, so they had to eat wings.
Yeah.
It just kind of makes sense. I can imagine them slobbering over chicken wings as they're getting ready for battle. Yeah. You know what I mean? Anyways... And the wings and the hot sauce tonight. Now everybody, when they listen to that song, they're going to think of wings and hot sauce coming down the mountainside.
Now when I think of that song, September, that's going to make me very hungry. In
September. What?
When I think of that song, that's going to just make me very hungry.
I think so too. I like to do that. So, and then he had the idea for me to do a video of me butchering the lyrics of the whole song.
Yeah, just do what, like, half of the Sabaton songs we do are just, like, lyric videos.
So do a lyric video but with the wrong lyrics?
Yeah.
Like, with my own made-up lyrics? I think that's doable, and I think it would be freaking hilarious. Anyways, we're here to do Afraid to Shoot Strangers, an Iron Maiden cover. One of my favorite, by the way, this is one of my favorite Iron Maiden songs. I really love this song, because there's a little bit of a ballad to it, but then there is a little bit of a kick at the right time, if you will. And it's about, I can totally see why Sabaton picked this song to do a cover. Because Afraid to Shoot Strangers is a song about somebody going to war, and he doesn't want to kill the other people, because he doesn't know who they are. They never did anything wrong to him. So why would I want to kill somebody who's never done anything to me? Like, they didn't kill my family. They didn't do anything wrong to me. So why would I want to kill them? They're there because they're probably forced to be there the same way I'm kind of forced to be there. So the whole song, Afraid to Shoot Strangers, is about that. Going to battle, going to war, and not wanting to kill people who didn't do anything wrong to
you. It doesn't make sense because it's about war. So
exactly. So that's what I'm saying. So it makes total sense that Sabaton would do a cover. Now, this song is really epic. This is a really good Iron Maiden song. I'm really excited. I've never heard this song. I was looking for covers for us to check out some covers on the channel. This one popped up. And I was like, I'm really interested to see what Chuck Liddell is going to do with this. Because Bruce Dickinson is not an easy guy to do a cover from. Like, he has a really, like, he has an incredible voice and range. So I'm really excited to see what little Chucky has done for
us. Plus, we haven't done a Sabaton song in a while.
Exactly. So, and I didn't want to go... To be honest with you, I wanted to do something different. I didn't want to just do, like, you know, Price of a Mile. We got to do Price of a Mile. But I didn't want to just do a Sabaton song. I wanted to do something different. So I thought, Afraid to Shoot Strangers.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Thank you.
sweat from my brow, but it's not the fear, 'cause I'd rather go now. Try to visualize the horrors that we lay ahead, the desert sun mound, a burial ground. To the time we partners in crime, when it comes to the time we'll be ready to die. God, let us go now and finish what's to be done. Thy kingdom come. It shall be done on earth. Trying to justify to ourselves the reasons to go. Should we live and let live? Forget or forgive? But how can we let them go on this way? The reign of terror, corruption must end, and we know deep down there's no other way. No trust, no reasoning, no more.
Mike, since you're the Sabatonian resident on site on the channel, I'm gonna let you go first and tell us what did you think about Afraid to Shoot Strangers cover, Sabaton covering Iron Maiden.
I like that.
Did you like it?
Yeah, because I gotta say, Bruce Dickinson and Chuck Liddell have very unique voices.
Very different. I mean, it's like...
They're very different, but both are very...
Very unique and very different, yeah. I mean, total polar opposites. Like, they couldn't be more different.
Yeah, because he has more graspy kind of...
He's got more of a deep voice, more graspy voice. Bruce Dickinson has a bigger range. Yeah, he has a bigger range.
But
what did you think of this song?
I like this...
So let me ask you a couple of... Let me try to...
Don't ask me, do I like this one better than the
other? No, I'm not going to ask you that. They're both very different.
They are both very different, so it's hard to really say.
So let me ask you this. I want to break it down, the song, into a few different elements. What did you think of his voice as far as delivering the lyrics of this song, in terms of this song has a lot of deep feelings in it. Like, it's almost... impossible for you to listen to this song and not feel something towards it. So what did you think about the way he delivered it vocally? Like,
he has a deep voice, so
it gives the song a different dynamic.
Yeah, and it sounds more sad coming from him.
I agree with you. I think when I hear this song from Iron Maiden, when they do the song, it almost feels like more of coming from a place of anger. Do you know what I mean? This one kind of felt like coming from a place of sadness. They both are the same song, but because of the way the vocals are delivered, they kind of give you a different perspective on how you feel towards it. What did you think of the guitar melodies? Because I thought they did a wonderful, they did a wonderful, wonderful job. They're Afraid to Shoot Strangers. That part, the original, I really like the original, because the way Bruce Dickinson says that Afraid to Shoot Strangers in that part is absolutely incredible. I really don't want to compare the two, because I really think this is a really, really good cover. It's a really good cover. I really like that guitar melody though.
Yeah.
That riff is so beautiful. I could listen to that. Dun, 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 dun. I can listen to that for hours. Just that alone. I love the melody that it has. I love the beauty that it has. But there's also so much sadness with that melody. It's absolutely beautiful. I love that. I absolutely love this song. It's one of my favorite Iron Maiden songs. And I was really interested to see what Sabaton was going to do with it, because they're a very different band.
Yeah.
Like, very different. So how are they going to grab this song and create it their own? I think they did a good job.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed it. I prefer the original. I'm not going to lie. I prefer the original. Just because I grew up listening to the original, that's the song that I'm used to. That's the style, the delivery that I'm used to. But I thought he did a great job. He really did a good job with this song. So, anything else?
No.
Do you have anything else to add? No? All right. Folks, this is it for today for this Sabaton Iron Maiden cover. We will be back tomorrow with more videos. All right, guys? See ya.
See ya.